Hey guys, Bayward Boondocker here. Something I noticed when I, like, this last week, I've been smelling this, like, awful smell in my RV. It smells like fertilizer. And I can't, like, pinpoint where the smell is coming from. But I know that my refrigerator went bad. Started leaking. Like, a common symptom of a bad refrigerator in an RV is the smell of ammonia. And it was so strong. And I researched it on the internet. Sure enough, it was my fridge. My fridge went bad. I guess that's just how these fridges work. It was leaking ammonia out of the cooler, the pipes there. So anyway, I've had it unplugged for a couple months. And just the other day, we had like a really hot day here in the Bay Area. It was like, well, it was really hot. It was only up to like 72, I think. But it was hot enough. And I'm thinking maybe that's what activated something in the refrigerator. And it's really stinking in here. Like I said, it smells like fertilizer. I just can't pinpoint it. So I'm assuming that it's going to be this refrigerator. I went outside this morning and I saw some flies, kind of like three flies coming, like hanging out on the vent, like where the vent for the fridge is on the outside of the RV. So, yeah, I think I need to get it removed. So, I can't get around to this stuff. Like, it's been on my to-do list forever, but it's really crucial right now. So I'm willing to like pay somebody to do this, to take it, to remove it. I've already got a refrigerator here. Just one of these like little kind of dorm refrigerator. It's a little bit larger than a dorm refrigerator, but, yeah, it works for me, but that's, runs on 110. Oops. I'm using my, camera here for video. I don't really use it that often. This is a Samsung Note 2. So anyway, like I said, I posted an ad on Craigslist and I just got home like an hour ago and, 2 hours ago. And like within 10 minutes of me posting the ad, someone said, call Mike. And with his phone number, that's his phone number. So I was like, okay, I'll call it. And this guy said, he's like really motivated to get this thing fixed. So he's going to come over and remove it tonight. So maybe I can get some video of that. Yeah, I don't know why so late. Makes you wonder. Let's see how this goes. Okay, and here's Mike. We're removing the refrigerator. Hey, Mike. Hey, buddy. And then here's the progress so far. We've removed the door. This thing is a bitch to get out. It's all these screws that are hidden everywhere. And it stinks like ammonia on the inside. It's really nasty.
Yeah, it's pretty bad.
It's coming out. Okay, well, we got the fridge out, but for some reason, the fridge is wider than the actual door here by like half an inch, quarter of an inch. So we're gonna remove the trim pieces. But look at that, we got the fridge out, so that's awesome. Really, we didn't even have to take off the trim pieces. We were able to just kind of wiggle it through the front door there, two people. It wasn't that heavy. Took him about an hour and a half to remove it all. And now I've got this gaping hole in the back. And I had this leftover, I don't know what you call that, foil insulation. It's the same stuff that I put in the back here to cover the windows. But it's like a foam board with foil on the outside, and then I had some Reflectix tape, Reflectix brand tape. It's like HVAC tape, and that's what I'm using to cover that gaping hole in the back. And then tomorrow I'm going to go to Home Depot and figure out a way to cover this gas line. So currently the gas is off, so I'll have to figure that out. And then I think there's a roof vent up here. Oh my god, yeah, and there's a lot, I'm losing a lot of air, like warm air through that hole, so I've got to plug that up as well. So the job is not done, but I'm really happy to have this out of here. And I don't smell that smell anymore, so that's awesome. Well, it's like 2 days later. I had this like foam board in there, this stuff, but I realized that hole right there is large enough for a skinny dude to crawl through and, you know, gain access to my RV. So the guy brought this board over, and it actually fits really well. I measured it to 23.5 inches, and luckily I have this skill saw, so I was able to make a really good cut. So now I'm just going to drill it in place. And here's what it looks like from the outside. I got this piece of wood in here cut to size. I haven't quite screwed it in yet. I went and bought 2-inch screws, and that seemed to be the perfect length to get the most screw in the wood without actually exiting my RV there. So there you go. And of course, this goes back on when I'm done. Damn it, I went to Home Depot and I got the wrong kind of plug to seal off the gap, the LPG line. I got the, I guess the female version of this right here. That's the one that I need when you're removing the refrigerator from an RV. That's how you, this is the part you need to cap off the propane. So I have to go to Home Depot again. That sucks. All right, made another trip to Home Depot, and I think I got the right one this time. So let me go ahead and install it and see if it works. That's what it looks like. It's the A159. Okay, now I'm just using 2 crescent wrenches to tighten it up. And it's pretty tight right now. I went ahead and added some of that Teflon tape. Teflon plumber's tape, and it seems like we got a good connection now. Turn the gas main back on, and we don't have spewing gas anywhere, so I take that as a good sign. Let me see if I can take a shower now. Well, I heard the pilot light. Yep, it lit. Now I can finally take a shower. I haven't had a shower in like a day, so this is really awesome. And then all that's left to do now is to properly cover these hot leads right here from the battery. And I've already put my screws in. This is a really dense wood, so if someone tries to kick it in, it's going to be really hard for them. And then I'm going to put like a block of wood right here as a stop for the bottom. And then I'm also going to have to caulk it in, because there's going to be a lot of drafts right there.